as you told us about your college life, so after college, we want to know a little about your first job. How was that experience? And what was your first big break that everybody has?
So my first assignment was CEO of my company.
That was your first assignment?
Strangest thing in life.
Okay.
My father became the president of the Indian Merchants Chamber.
Okay.
And so he left the firm to me to sink or to swim.
Okay.
And so I learned hard way to swim.
Okay, and how old were you?
I was 21.
Okay.
I was a very early chartered accountant, just married. And he put me in the center of things and said, run the firm.
Okay.
So my first job was CEO of the firm.
Oh.
Then, in a real sense, I went and worked in Chicago at Arthur Young and Company. At that time, it used to be called, in Chicago.
Okay.
And there I learned how important it is to apply everything you've learned to real life.
Real life.
And how important it is to lead by actually performing.
Example.
So I was, there was a 15-day induction program before you got to do any work.
Okay.
And at the end of it, there was a test.
Mm.
And the prize to the person who stood first was to go and do the audit of McDonald's Corporation.
Okay.
That was the prize.
Okay.
So I fought for it and won it.
Wow.
So I was put on McDonald's Corporation audit. So I was there when we signed the 1979 annual accounts in 1980 January. And it was my first exposure to a very large global multinational setting. I used to work in the headquarters of McDonald's.
Wow.
And, it was extremely exciting to get challenged all the time. But the most, I mean, this experience gives me goosebumps today.
Mm-hmm.
They just gave me an air ticket and said, go to Dallas.
Okay.
I was in Chicago.
Huh.
It was the first flight I'd ever taken in my life, long distance, to get to Chicago.
Okay.
So they handed over an airline ticket to me and said, go to Dallas. You need to sort of audit four of the McDonald's outlets over there. So I got off at Dallas Airport, and it was almost like magic happening around me, because the rental car came and stood at the curbside, because already they had given advance intimation. Hertz was a client of Arthur Young, so they could do all of this. And so the Hertz car came up, and the fellow handed over a key to me and said, now drive. Go wherever you want to go. And so I had to find my way using, at that time there was no Google
Maps. Yeah.
So I had to really have, I had a physical map from which I found all the locations of all the four stores. I did the audit and learned to, you know, learn on the fly.
Yeah, exactly.
That is something that we learned immensely. The other big learning experience was that the computer-based auditing and the manual auditing was getting merged.
Okay.
So we had 2 weeks of seminar in West Virginia, near Washington, D.C. In a wooded area, very lovely setting, but intense work where we had to figure out how you can do all auditing using computers.
Okay.
So that was my first brush at the age of, what was it, 23, with with computers and systematically doing.
So the big data shift, like from
the old. I mean, I just shifted, my whole mind shifted from the manual world to the computer world. When it was just fusing, that was very, very important.
Okay.
That has stood me in good stead all my life. As you know, today I'm a technology buff.
So, sir, moving on from that, talking about right now, we've also, from the perspective of the youth, it is a little different time. So, there is the trade war going on, there are a few things which upset us in the corporate world. So what do you think about that? How is our position right now? And how can we do better after we graduate in this kind of an environment?
The world has never been more peaceful than it is today.
Mm.
We have the lowest number of wars going on in the world.
True.
In history.
Mm.
The world is abundant.
Mm.
We operate from a sense that there is a shortage.
Okay.
Whereas the world is actually abundant.
Abundant. Okay. So, sir, from this perspective, from the personal perspective, I completely agree with that. So, how do you apply to this in an organization? Because a lot of times when organizations are facing a change, accepting the change is very difficult for a lot of people. So, as the leader, as the CEO, chairman, the independent director of so many boards, how did you lead people to accept that kind of change in an organization?
So, again, we used largely the principles of, very simple, integrity, transparency, accountability.
Okay.
If you push these three principles,
mm.
then the governance of the organization becomes better.
Okay.